Hello and welcome back to Piccolo Podcast. Here we meet a different instrument each time and explore some of the music and sounds that they can make. Today I would like to introduce you to the piano and Da-hee, who will be playing the piano today.
Hi everyone.
Hi Da-hee. Please tell us how you create those sounds on the piano.
Of course. The piano has 88 different keys, which I press with my fingers. Each of these keys, when pressed, hits a different string. And each of these strings make a different sound. Some make high sounds. And some make low sounds. I can press lots of keys at the same time, and it sounds like this. Or just one key at a time.
Now it's time for our first piece called Tutelage. This music was written to create an image of children arguing. What does the music make you imagine? What could the children be arguing about? Hey, it was my turn to go on the bike. That's not fair, you're not sharing. Or maybe the music makes you imagine something else. What's the next piece that you'll be playing?
The next piece I will play is going to tell us the story of Baba Yaga the witch.
Before we begin, please join in and pretend to cast some spells at home. Can you cast angry, scary spells? Can you cast happy, kind spells? Cast mysterious spells. There was a little girl who was lost in the woods. She was hungry too, but had with her only a few crumbs of ham and cheese. Eventually, she happened upon a house. Thinking that someone might be able to help her find her way home, she decided to see who was inside. In the front yard, there was a dog who was starving and gnawing at a bone with no meat. "Here, have some ham." The little girl gave him her last bit of ham. At the front door, an old lady opened it. "Hello," the little girl said. "Can you help me? I'm lost." "Come in," said the old lady. "Warm yourself by the fire and I'll run you a bath." By the fire there was a black cat, and the little girl sat there with him while the lady went off to the kitchen. The cat was starving and his bowl was empty. "Here, have some cheese." And the little girl gave him her last bit of cheese. Then the cat turned to her and spoke. "That is no kind old lady, but in fact, Baba Yaga the witch. She intends to eat you, so run while you can."
Mm-hmm.
But how will I ever? I will help you, said the cat. Take this comb, and when she is close, throw it behind you. It will sprout into a forest so thick that even Baba Yaga won't be able to force her way through, said the cat. The little girl snuck out the house straight away. She passed the dog in the yard, and he said, Take this cloth. When Baba Yaga is close, throw it behind you, and it will make a river so wide that it will slow even Baba Yaga down. Now run, said the dog. When Baba Yaga came back, she noticed that the little girl was gone. She ran out the house and started chasing her at immense speeds. The little girl could hear her approaching, and she threw the cloth behind her. At once it transformed into a wild, vast river. Who helped my meal escape? Who gave her my magic cloth? It was I, said the dog. That little girl showed me kindness, and she gave me ham, which is more than you have ever done. Baba Yaga struggled through the river, but when she got to the other side, it wasn't long before she had almost caught up with the little girl again. The little girl threw the comb behind her. In an instant, it sprouted into a thick, tangled forest. Baba Yaga tried, but she could not pass through. Who helped my meal escape? Who gave her my magic comb? She roared ferociously. It was I, said the cat. That little girl showed me kindness and gave me cheese, which is more than you have ever done. So thanks to the dog and the cat, the little girl finally reached home and was safe at last.
Before we have to go, we have time for one more piece. The girl with the flaxen hair. Close your eyes. What do you see?
Thank you, Da-hee, and thank you, Piano. That was such calming music. What a lovely way to finish the episode. To everyone listening, I hope you'll join again next time when we'll meet another instrument. But for now, bye!
Bye!